Well, personally, I did a bad job turning the ball over, so I got to work on that. That's my fault, but I felt like my teammates, they made big shots. And then, you know, Ben was that last steal he had at the end was amazing. That was the game beside Mike's shot in the corner. So they came up, but we got a lot of things to work on.
When Jared Dudley got in your face in the third quarter, what did you make of the whole incident?
I mean, first of all, he's a nobody, so. And when, you know, opponents trying to do stuff like that, that's just to get us out of the game. Especially, I'm too valuable for my team. That's why I didn't react. I did not do anything. And I didn't think that was a flagrant foul because I played the ball too. But in that type of situation, I just got to stay composed and be mature and let it go because my teammates need me more than they need him. So, you know, I just got to be mature.
Speaking of your value, what's the hardest part of going game to game, maybe playing, sometimes maybe not, and being able to stay ready and in rhythm?
It sucks. You know, you go days without practicing and without playing, and you got to come in and, you know, and play a game, and you got to be in shape. It's hard to get in the rhythm, but I just got to push through. You know, I'm dealing with a painful knee issue, but it does not allow me to play. You know, I'm still out there fighting for my teammates, and you know, because I feel like we have a great opportunity to go to the finals and win it all.
And you have an opportunity to close this out in Philadelphia. What's the best way to not allow them any confidence in game five?
The keys, not turning the ball over. Tonight, like I said, I did a bad job protecting the ball. I'm definitely going to do better. And offensive rebounds, and we got to limit the threes. That's the key. Good job, man.
All right, thank you, JoJo. Congrats.